Welcome back, guys, to another episode on the To The Grid channel. We're in the race trailer. And the race trailer has done me good over the years. It's a great setup. Holds the car, the four-wheeler, toolbox, all that stuff. But a lot of people that know me, when I'm at the track, I kind of like to party. You know, I like to get a good group of people together, play some tippy cup, beer pong, flip cup, whatever you call it, or just simply hang out and listen to some music. So, I've had a radio in here, as you can see, the surround sound from an old home theater unit. And it kind of worked. I mean, it's janky. I don't know. This thing would always slide off going down the road, fall. Actually, it never actually fell. I suppose the cords held it back. So then, like this weekend, for my Cedar Spark, as you guys have seen in other videos, I have the radio for that. Let me just pop that on a table outside and jam to that. We're gonna go bigger. My boys at Sound Connection got me a little ambitious. And we're probably gonna have a video on what got me started on this project. If not before, maybe after this video on the channel. But they took a trailer similar to mine. This is a 26-foot trailer. They have a 30, I believe it is, maybe a 32, triple axle. This is a tandem. And they put six subwoofers, eight, if I recall right, mids, and four tower speakers on this thing. And it is ridiculous. But badass at the same time. Now, we're not going to go quite that crazy because you don't even want to know what it costs them to do that and their materials and labor and time to do this. And I don't either. But I'm betting you it's upwards of 15 grand or more. All Rockford Fosgate stuff, right? Really nice top-end stuff. And these guys do an awesome job installing things like this. But we're going to do a little bit smaller system on this one. And so what we're going to do right now is start tearing up the old home theater system and preps for my boy Nate to come over. You'll see him probably later in this video to help me wire in. I'll show you what we're going to use. We're going to use a PX2, I believe it's called. PMX2, sorry, Rockford Fosgate head unit. This thing is great for like side-by-sides, boats. And we're gonna mount it like, probably, bear with me here, probably behind the door, like right in this area. When you're probably thinking, well, Rich, why would you put it behind the door? Well, then you can't use it. I thought the same thing. But being as the technologies we have today, Bluetooth and whatnot, just connect your phone to it, and you control your volume and everything from your phone. So, but if you really do need to it, you can just open the door. We were going to put it over here so it was always accessible, but then, you know, the unit is about 3.5 inches deep, so we're going to put it up here where it goes inside the cabinets towards the top area here and just run our wires along the top all nice and clean. So I'll show you what we got down here. Well, it's kind of a mess, but so we do have a battery already. We got a winch. This is coming out. This was for an AC unit. We fixed that this weekend. We got a power inverter and a bunch of wires that are coming out. This is all old stuff from the surround sound radio. I got a little too ambitious before I got the GoPro out, so my bad. But so yeah, I'm gonna start ripping this stuff out. So all these speakers are, I thought about leaving this one for just inside for music, and then on top of that, our RGBs that we had underneath my awning, the blue took a crap in them. So we're gonna redo that, and I think I have enough to actually like double loop it so it'd be twice as bright. So I think we're gonna do that too in this video. So without further ado, I'm gonna start ripping stuff apart. Alright guys, a couple days later, and now we have a Nate with a drill. Oh god. We're gonna start installing the Rockford head unit. I think what we're going to try and do is we're going to go into this cabinet here and drill outwards. So we have the head unit hidden, the wiring hidden in here, and that will put it somewhere in this location, depending on where the hole saw comes through. So it's going to be a little low, but and then when the door is open, that's okay. It's all Bluetooth, so once you connect to it, it won't matter. So I guess it's time to drill a hole. Oh God. All right, Nate, drilled our where we think we want it. Now there is no turning back. Oh boy, drilling holes. Oh, there you are. Oh, hi.
You want me to go through?
Did you see just the tip?
Yeah.
All right. Let's shut this door. Ooh, is that, it's that high? I actually kind of like where that is.
Okay,
let me just double check before you...
before I press the go button?
Hang on. I'm nervous. All right, send it.
Every time.
Great. How will we get that out now?
You don't.
Oh.
You'll never hear it though. That one fell on the inside.
Now we have a hole in my trailer.
There'll be more.
All right, let's get this head unit in here. All right, guys. So we got the head unit through the hole. But there's a metal plate in here that will sandwich the weather seal to the trailer so moisture and stuff doesn't get in here. So we bent that plate and I shoved it in there and then bent it straight while Nate fed the head unit through. Now we're going to pre-drill a couple holes for the bolts here that secure it. And then that thing will sandwich tight. And there's a rubber foam seal here so no moisture will get in the trailer. So. All right, man. Drill some more holes in my trailer. Metal must not be very thick, huh?
You know, it's super thin.
Oh yeah, look at that. Do we peel the sticker or do we wait?
You peel it.
Oh. Oh, the satisfaction. And then you got a trim plate that hides the screws. Look at that. That looks factory. Not so bad. Only took 5 holes in my trailer, but.
There'll be more.
All right. So now we're gonna get the speakers going. Those are gonna go. I haven't decided. Do we do 2 on this side?
I have one in case
you have your door open. 2 over there? Oh, that's a good point. See, then we have the door closed and you can't see them.
Oh, here.
So we'll just put them over here. Or hear them. That's a good point. To hear the speakers. Should probably keep it under the awning though, huh?
Yeah.
To keep as much moisture off them as possible. So we're going to figure out the exact placement on those and then we'll start mounting those, I think. But yeah, got the head unit in. Got a lot of real estate to work with. We just gotta watch out for these things. So we'll probably go like more centered or something like here. So, all right, Nate's grabbing the speakers and we'll figure that out. Guys, I'm having second thoughts. And I'm gonna show you why. That thing is huge. We gotta drill a hole that big in my trailer? Guys, look how big, that's how big the speakers are. I mean, look at this. My hand's gotta be what, 10 inches? This, oh my God. I really hope this sounds good when we're done. Is it gonna sound good?
Yeah.
Well, that wasn't very reassuring.
It's the ha ha, like, yeah.
All right.
You heard our trailer, right?
Yeah, their trailer's badass. We're gonna put a video in this video too, or at least a link to that video, because that's what kind of, I kind of wanted to do something like this for a while, but that's what really motivated to finally do this. These guys at Sound Connection did, how many speakers? Like, explain the setup. What is it? It's like a 30-foot trailer.
35-foot.
35-foot trailer.
8 6.5s.
Which is what we're putting on. We're putting 4 of those on mine. Yep. Yeah, we're putting 4 4.5s. They have 8.
4 towers. So, 6 subs.
Oh my god.
6 amps. 1 massive head unit. And now we're going to be adding more speakers too.
There's like, would you figure like 15 grand in stuff in that trailer?
15 to 20.
This is like a $40,000 trailer rolling down the road just to advertise sound equipment. But you should hear this thing, guys. It's like better than being in a live concert. It rocks. Things look like they were meant to be there. Nice and level. Look at that. Got 2 more to put in. Rockford Fosgate. Hooking it up. Actually, I should say Sound Connection boys hooking it up. Yep, we can tie them together, follow the seam up, and run them all the way down this channel. And the other speaker should be, I think, about here, because the awning ends like a little bit before the end of the trailer. So, yeah, it's like 3 screws in. So, 1, 2, 3. See, I think we'll put one here and here. It looks like it'll be. But yeah, they don't stick out too far. They look too bad. It's not like anything's there anyway. You know, nothing here before.
Slowly we'll leave this.
Yep, that ain't gonna mess with nothing. So, cool. Well, you think the drill's cooled off yet?
We can
start drilling the other holes. Oh crap, dude, that thing probably gets like 200 degrees in your hand. You can't even touch it for a while.
Yeah.
And it chews through batteries. Good thing we brought extras and extra drills.
2, 1, that one's done.
I think I have a charger here, but it's not a Milwaukee one. It's a DeWalt.
Third battery.
We got one battery left of the Milwaukee and a couple left for the DeWalt. We'll see. We'll get it done. 2 more holes to drill, 2 more speakers to put in, and then we start wiring everything up.
Yeah.
Let's get it.
Yeah.
All right. Now the fun part, the metal. So we tried something, and we're going to try it with the metal too, because the blade's getting kind of dull. Mm-hmm. She's been used. We're gonna mark this with the bit, and then we're gonna go through with a drill and drill a bunch of holes. Then it's that much less metal we have to drill, hoping that gives the saw something to bite too. Yeah. So we were able to get the other two in pretty good, but that thing's
like,
ready for a new. Yeah, you can run your hand like right across it now. You think it'll even cut it?
Should.
All right, let's mark them up and we'll drill some holes. We're gonna call this Ancient Chinese Secret.
Yeah.
It's gotta help. I mean,
you know,
you figure it's that much less metal to cut, so.
Who's a genius?
That guy.
Yeah, the whole thing worked. I don't know if you'll see it in the time lapse, but we drilled through this thing like 10 times as fast as we did those two holes, just by drilling like 10 holes around the perimeter when we marked it with the hole saw. It went right through. Like, took like a solid minute and a half, maybe, each hole. Heck yeah! I just need like a little, like, little mouth, and we got a little smiley face on the trailer.
Ready to go frisbee golfing.
Hey, we got new frisbee discs too. Axel, ready?
He's gonna try biting it.
Go! He's like, what the heck is that, Dad? Not interested. No? He's a good boy. Alright, let's get some more speakers in there.
Yeah. They're right behind him.
Alright, now that we got the Rockford Fosgate system, we gotta add to the sticker collection down here. One of us. Where should we put it? Right in the center? Put silver on silver. We can't have that. Go right there. Go right above. We'll leave that clear on there just so it doesn't fall. Go Ryan Turk sign this. Hang this back up. All right, guys, we're on to the next day now. Nate had to take off and take care of his dogs. We ran and got some wiring and some zip tie fasteners. So that's how we're gonna secure everything up here. We have this stuff called 5-wire and 9-wire. So there's 9 wires in here. So all your speaker channels and then what would typically be your remote wire is the 5th wire. And we tucked everything up here. Ran the wires behind. We're gonna attempt to do the same thing with the RGBs, which is what we're doing right now. And we're using the 5-wire, even though we only need 4 wires for that. But it already comes in the Lumis 5 wires for that. So we haven't tightened these down yet, just so we have any adjustment until everything's all wired in. Started working on the RGB. I was really hoping there's a cleaner way I can do this. Maybe I'll find some conduit or something. I wanted to go behind the panel, but there's a beam right here, so then I can't cross over and go straight up. So this is going to be a little bit not as clean of an install right here as I would like it to be. I suppose I could have ran each separate one, but that would have been a ton more wiring. So we'll try this for now, and I'll find some bezeling. We have some panels we're going to put on the back here to give us a little bit cleaner look. Those will be installed later. Probably won't see those in this video. But then we're wiring, so we just cut a slice here, we pull the wires we need, we run wire up to them, and then we're going to tape all this back. This will be sort of a clean look here, not crazy, but, you know, it'll work. Luckily it's inside, you don't see it, but I don't like a cobbled mess either. And then up here, we're going to get some fasteners for the light.
And so far we only have the red hooked up, but I have tested with this RGB controller, which is just a cheap one I got online. So far it powers the strip outside, this, and then two of the four speakers I had tested hooked up, and it seemed to work just fine. So I'm pretty sure with two more, the other two down here, it'll still work good, but we won't know until we get it hooked up. So I'm gonna continue wiring the RGB up, and then I will get you guys a video of the final product, and I'll probably do one at dark also, so you guys can kind of see how well it illuminates everything. I'm not really sure how bright the speakers are. I haven't quite seen them yet, just in the daylight here, so. But yeah, so the awning light and the speakers will be on the same controller, so they will be the same colors. That way you don't have like five different colors going on at once, but. Two more to go. So far, the controller is supporting the light strip and the two speakers. We're hoping that it'll support the other two, because it is a cheap $8 RGB controller, which they're usually not very expensive anyway, unless you get a multi-channel one. So, it's payday. We're gonna extend this awning light too. It's going to loop down all the way to those speakers, and then we're going to loop it back so it's twice as bright. So I'm hoping the additional LEDs also won't cause an issue, but we won't know until we try. And if we do run into an issue, we'll get a different RGB controller, I guess. So there's a few other ones out there, but this one was already in the trailer. Well, I already installed it in the trailer for the awning light, and we're going to try and use it for the speakers and everything, and we'll see how it works. So I'm gonna continue wiring up the back two speakers with the RGBs. Probably about gonna wrap it up, so yeah. So I'm gonna do that now.
To my house. It's my house.
Sorry, not sorry for party rocking there. I'm pretty excited to have this done. I've been wanting to have something close to this, but this turned out a lot better than I thought it was going to in my head. The only thing I don't like is the exposed wires inside the trailer, which I'll probably run some conduit over it or something to make my OCD not go crazy there. The big reason why I didn't run some of the wires behind the paneling is because those wires needed to connect together, and there's a beam that separates each speaker, the structure of the trailer, and without drilling a hole in there and all that stuff, which taking paneling off was way more work than I wanted to do. But turned out pretty good. It sounds amazing. It is so crisp. There is no amplifier on this head unit. It is the straight PMX3 or whatever Rockford Fosgate head unit with the 4 PM1, I believe. Rockford Fosgate Marine speakers. So these things are good for winter, snow, all that stuff, rain, whatever. So we will always be able to party rock at the campsite at the track. So yeah. I'm pretty pumped. I'm excited to use it. We got a Proving Grounds weekend coming up. We'll have it out there for that. And we're also probably going to be bringing the Sound Connection trailer you probably saw in this video. We're going to bring that out for a demo and kind of show people what those guys are capable of doing and what their products can do that they sell. So yeah, pretty excited for that. There will also be footage on that event. It is not typically what Proving Grounds would be, because of the COVID stuff going on this year, but we're still gonna go. We're gonna compete in the autocross Friday. I believe there's only 100 cars from what I saw on the car count. So we'll be taking the C7 Vet out there for that, putting the Falcon 615K Plus tires and wheels back on the car to run that event. We ran the stock wheels and tires, the Michelins at Power Cruise, which I like running those because of the camber setup on the car, and chew those tires up instead of my track tires. So, all right, guys, I think that's going to wrap this video up. I think I'm going to go jam out some more and party by myself in front of my newly speakered up, lit up trailer. So, all right, guys, until the next one, keep it real.